First of all, I want you to know that I come from Route 4, Liberty, Mississippi. Now, that's 12 miles west of Macomb, Mississippi, 65 miles due northeast of Baton Rouge, Louisiana, and 116 miles due north of New Orleans, Louisiana. It was there that I first saw the light of day out in Amite County, September the 28th, 1926. I was born there. Now, as I grew up in that community, the only extracurricular activities that we engaged in was to go coon hunting or go to revival meeting if we had a crop laid by. And that's all we did except work. And this particular day that I want to tell you about is one evening when we were going coon hunting. We had a pack of hounds. When we went to mill with our corn to get it ground up, we'd get some ground for dog bread, and we'd get some ground for just regular corn meal for human consumption. This particular day, we wasn't too busy. All we had done is just cut down a few fence rows, shucked and shelled some corn and went to mill, drew up some water because that was wash day, helped get the sow back, what rooted out from under the net wire fence, sharpened two sticks of stove wood real sharp and pegged them down over the bottom wire of the fence where the hog couldn't root out no more. And had a rat killing. If I'm lying, I'm dying. We had rat killings in those days. Well, this particular day after we got through the rat killing, I walked out on the front porch and I hollered, hey! And them dogs come out from under the house barking. They knew we was going coon hunting. And I hollered again, and my neighbor way across the sage patch hollered back, and that meant I'll meet you halfway. We met in the middle of that sage patch, and he had his dogs, old Brummy and Queen and Spot, and I had Tory and Little Red and old Trailer. And we went out into the swamps, and we started hunting. Oh, we was having such a fine time. Caught four great big ones. I heard a racket, and it scared me, and I whooped my carbide light, what I had wired to my cap around there, and I was looking in the vicinity of where I heard the racket coming from. And the beam of light hit a man right in the face, and it like him to have scared me slapped to death because we was hunting on this man's place. I said, Mr. Barron, is that you? He said, yes, Jerry. What are y'all doing? We hunting. How many have you caught? Four great big ones. He said, well, boys, glad to see you. Y'all want to spend the rest of the evening hunting with me and John. Well, I looked, and lo and behold, there was John Eubanks, a man that lived on Mr. Barron's place. John Eubanks was a great American. He was a professional tree climber. He didn't believe, I'm telling you the truth. He didn't believe in shooting no coon out of no tree. It was against his upbringing. He taught us from birth, from the day we were born till the age we could keep listening to him. Give everything a sporting chance. Whatever you do, give it a sporting chance. He'd have been a great conservationist today if he'd be here. And John said, take a crosscut saw coon hunting with you. When you tree a coon, hold the dogs and cut the tree down. Or either climb the tree and make the coon jump in amongst the dogs. Give him a sporting chance. A lot of times we'd climb a tree and make a coon jump in amongst 20 dogs, but at least he had the option of whooping all them dogs and walking off if he wanted to. This is strictly left up to the coon. So I said, Mr. Barron, we'd be glad to go hunting with you. You know, he was a rich man. He had sold a lot of cotton during the First World War for a dollar a pound. He had some world-renowned dogs. And we hollered three or four times, and they started hunting. And we listened, and directly, old Brummy didn't bark at nothing but a coon. He had a deep voice. And when he cut out on him, it was a coon. Don't worry about no possum or no bobcat. Brummy was running a coon. And then old Trailer and old Highball and them famous dogs and Mr. Barron's got in there with them, and old John Eubanks would holler, hey, speak to it. And my brother Sonny would holler, hey, look fine. And oh, it was beautiful. Now y'all get this picture. About that time they treed, we rushed down into the swamps. And there the dogs were, treed up the biggest sweet gum tree in all of Amit River swamps. It was huge. You couldn't reach around this tree. There wasn't a limb on it for a while. Way up there, huge tree. And I looked around at John and I said, John, I don't believe you can climb that tree. And it hurt John's feelings. He pooched his lips out, got fighting mad. He said, there ain't a tree in all these swamps that I can't climb. And he got his Brogan shoes off and he eased up to that sweet gum tree and he hung his toenails in that bark and he got his fingernails in there and he kept easing up the tree, working his way toward that bottom limb, and he finally got to it and he started on up into this big tree. Knock him out, John. It won't be long. And John worked his way on up to the top of the tree and whoo, what a big one. And he reached around in his overalls and got that sharp stick and he drawed back and he punched the coon. But it wasn't a coon. It was a lynx. We call them souped-up wildcats in Amit County. And that thing had great big tushies coming out of its mouth and red big claws on the end of its feet. And people, that thing attacked it, John, up in the top of that tree. Whoa! You could hear John squall. What's the matter with John? I don't have no idea. What in the world's happening to John? Knock him out, John. Whoa! This thing's killing me. The whole top of the tree was shaking. The dogs got to biting the bark of the tree and fighting one another underneath the tree. And I was kicking them back. You dogs, get away. What's the matter with John? Knock him out, John. Whoa! This thing's killing me. And John knew that Mr. Barron toted a pistol in his belt to shoot snakes with. And he kept hollering, whoa, shoot this thing. Have mercy, this thing killing me. Shoot this thing. And Mr. Barron said, John, I can't shoot up in there. I might hit you. John said, well, just shoot up in here amongst us. One of us got to have some relief.